have a skilled, skilled model, SIPO skilled model ng urban and distance. So use this information, average distance of fuel from the earth, average na 384,400 kilometers. Sige, okay niya. So medyo malaki pa rin. Kasi alam natin din ba ang circumference ng the moon is just 1/4 of the earth. Tama, di ba? Imagine yung mas maliit na lang. Mas maliit pa sa amin. Correct. Anyway, ito lang yung information na nilalaman natin. Average distance ng moon from Earth and then average circumference ng Earth. Now, how do we use this information for us to have an accurate scale model? And you can use this, you can use this as motivation for your students in the future. Okay? Ilang beses na mas malaki ang distansya ng buwan sa Earth kumpara doon sa kanyang diameter, ng Earth. Subukan niyo kunin yung ratio. Ratio ng distance of moon from Earth to the average circumference of Earth. Ano yung ratio niyan? Ilang beses na mas malaki ang distance ng moon from Earth dito sa average circumference. How many times? sizes from the bones of rocks sa basa napakalaki, no? Okay, of course, yung pinakamalaki ay yung pinagaling kong sila the last largest asteroid ay Ceres, diba? But they are million kilometers apart. So this one is a very mistaken installation of the asteroid belt. Our solar system is very empty. Okay, so you are safe to travel the solar system na walang makakabang asteroid. We are talking here a very large space. Okay? So asteroid belt does not look like a ring or rather circling the sun. Okay. Now, next day, let's check that. The last category. Sabi natin na niya. It's a section of sky watching. Okay, misconception about stars and the universe. May nakita kayo sa mga computer. Anyway, one misconception about stars would be the sun here is cold 5 billion years from now. It's a supernova explosion 5 billion years from now. Okay, and again, that's a misconception. Because our sun will not undergo supernova explosion 5 billion years from now. There are some factors that affect the light cycle of stars, and we know that it's the size that matters, right? It's actually the mass that matters, no? But for an average star like our sun, it will not explode like in the near future, but okay. It will just produce so called the planetary nebula. And later I'll show you what is a planetary nebula. Now, okay, the star's mass determines what life path it will take. And our sun is somehow here, which is a category of all of the stars. And those stars will have high mass. So they are the ones who have the tendency to explode. Okay? So this is in terms of the relative of mass of ibang stars compared to our sun. Our mass is one solar mass. Tapos kung ang mass ng sun star is 3 times massive than the mass of our sun, then eventually it will category. Tapos if a certain star is 8 times massive than our sun, then that is a high mass star. Okay? Ngayon, evolution of the main sequence expansion of red giant. So what happens after our sun, pagkatapos na siya ng main sequence stage. Okay? So if we're going to look at the interior of our of a star, okay? So here we have this hydrogen fusion signal, kung saan yung fusion, okay? And then as those hydrogen atoms, hydrogen may are fused together, they form helium 4 or helium ashes, okay? So take note that a star is actually an object, kung saan nila pressure in. Pressure going from outside, going out, and the force of gravity going in. If the pressure goes up towards the star is balanced, no, or equal to the inward pull of gravity, then the star is in equilibrium. Now, during the late main sequence stage, kapag nagpubos na yung mag, yung very first source ng fuel ng sun, which is hydrogen, then eventually, the tendency is for it to decrease the temperature inside. Kasi naubusan na, di ba? Malaki na ubus. Pag bumaba na lang bahagya ang temperature, following some basic science or chemistry laws, when we have a decrease in temperature, what do you think will happen to the pressure? Bababa again. So, which should dominate temporarily? The gravity or pressure? Okay? update. So at 8, a meeting was staged at Star Villa, San Jose. Okay? To compensate for the decreasing pressure inside. Okay? Now, of course, habang nag-pressure yung araw na nagkakaroon naman ng inward controls dahil sa hindi masyado pa sa mga condition, no? Eventually, the core will begin to heat up again. Diba? And it will now be a second round of nuclear fusion. Okay? Tama ba? Ngayon, pag nangyari na yun ngayon, let's start the second round of nuclear fusion, no? Well, yung outer parts ng sun, the moon star, will be forced to expand, and eventually it becomes into seven, red becomes red giant. Habang nagtatakotrak ulo sa loob, yung outer atmosphere, nag-expand na. Okay? Tapos yung nagtatakot sa loob, na nag-compress, okay, itinatawag natin white dwarf. So, a queen ng ating sun is probably to become a white dwarf eventually, and then to form a planetary nebulae. So, yung nasa gitna, exposed core. Okay, exposed core sa gitna. Hindi siya sasabog. Kasi, again, hindi siya magaligan. Pangalawa, it's not rich in very dense metallic elements for it to explode. Hindi kasi yung base anatomy ng massive stars. Okay? Massive stars tend to form heavier elements doon sa inner core, and eventually, as it forms iron, so yung iron na yan, hindi na siya ganun ka-stable to fuse together more. Okay, but accumulation of iron inside the star's interior would produce an explosion. Now, next we have misconception. Okay, all galaxies are moving away from us. There's the center of the universe where the Big Bang occurred, the aliens of the Hadron Collider arise, huge events, and so on. Sino ba rin yung mga visual na dito dito sa loob? Pag-check it pag-alit. What is your mind? Okay. So, number one, all galaxies are moving away from us. Okay? As implied by the Hubble's law. Which space that farther an object is from us, the faster it's moving. It's not moving faster. There is just more space between us than is expanding, so it appears to be moving faster. Remember that our space is going because of the expanding, and because of this expansion, the distances between the objects, those are space, and those are universe, tend to increase. It's not really the galaxies or the heavenly bodies that move away from each other, but it's the space that really expands that make all the objects seem to be sitting away from each other. Kaya di ba yung classic experiment dito is to have a balloon. Bago hilipan yung balloon, mag-drawing ka ng dalawang dots, 1 centimeter apart. Pag hilipan mo yung balloon, pag lumoko, yung 1 centimeter na distance between A and B will not be 1 centimeter anymore. So it's mas malayo na sa sinasay sa isa. Di ba? Okay, next. And his wife is being very mean. Sino mga biological science major dito? Sino mga kabayo? What better is the phenotype of an individual? What better is the phenotype or outer appearance of an individual? Genetics yan, di ba? Oh. Di ba yung ating, yung ano natin, di ba? Yung physical makeup natin, our physical makeup is dictated by our genes. Di ba? By our genes. And our genetic makeup is actually a product of millions of years of evolution. We tend to pass on traits to the next generation. Di ba? We tend to pass our traits to the next generation. Okay, and our environment plays a major role in passing our traits to the next generation. If we have those advantageous traits, if we have those good traits, because it is supported by the environment, because we are adapted to that particular environment, then the tendency is for us to pass on those desirable traits to the next generation. So, the environment plays a role in upping our physical makeup. Tama?
Yes.
Bakit hindi kayo na ito? Ibig ko sabihin, from the planet that they come from, ito ba yung desirable traits for them para magbuhay doon sa planeta nila? Diba? Why do they have two eyes? Diba? Why do they have bilateral symmetry? Ganun din ba yung condition ng planet nila to our planet? So why do we have such noses? Dalawang organs din. Do they have lungs? Diba? Sa tanong, in the air that can enter inside. So before we can depict alien creatures like this, isipin nyo muna ang genetics at adaptation. In this world, diba, lahat ng mga members ng animal kingdom have physical structures at that, na merong pinagamalus sa environment nila. Diba? So dapat pupunta sa din dito, we don't show off magbubuhay pa sila ulit. Kasi we are inhaling oxygen. And actually, oxygen is toxic as far as chemistry is concerned. Okay? Oxygen is a good oxidizing agent, ang oxygen. It's because of its high electronegativity. Diba? Oxygen is actually poisonous. And we are adapted to oxygen. O bakit tumitutok sila dito? Bakit hindi sila namamatay sila? Diba dapat sila yung namamatay kasi sila yung so, that's it. Any questions on clarification? Session na minabalik mo na. Anyway, so much for that. Maraming